Hey, yes, hello. Back with another episode on Ladybug in Grasshopper and Rhino. Last time, or in the first episode, we looked at how to create a data-driven windrows, the one you see here. And then we looked into, like, a closer look into what else could we analyze or how to analyze data within the tools in here. And today, so that last one was a bit of a dry but necessary kind of tutorial. And today we will build a data-driven 3D chart, something like this. So basically, you can use any data out of your weather data set or sets. So here, for example, we use the temperature, and but also then the dew point temperature over the whole year, and it creates this chart. And we will also look into the ways that filter out certain areas of that data. For example, a certain temperatures above or below a key temperature. So we just start from scratch. Let me just hide that so it's a bit faster. I'll just build it very quickly. It's always good to just redo it because then it creates some kind of muscle memory. Yeah, so we need to have the ladybug component. This is the main component. I went through all this in the first episode, so if you need a more in-depth explanation, please revisit that first episode. Then we need the download component that will help us to download the weather data. We need a toggle. By the way, if you have a better way to do these things, always let me know. I'm happy to learn. Then a ladybug, the import component, and the URL, the weather file URL component, which we then link with this, and the panel to paste the URL. Yeah, so then we click on the toggle, go to our weather file. Let's choose something more prominent, for example, the Manhattan Central Park. Copy link to clipboard, so it should be there already. Paste. Never enter, because if you enter, then it doesn't understand. Just click outside. Now it should work. This should turn gray, and this is green, so it means it was loaded successfully. Then we could copy this here and feed it with the README output. And it says hourly weather data for New York Central Park Observatory, Belvedere Castle, New York, US is imported successfully. Perfect. So in order to create a 3D chart, you just need to click the Ladybug 3D chart, or you can also double click anywhere in your workspace and then Ladybug, or let's say 3D chart, then you will get the right component. So yeah, now you have the 3D chart component here. Then you can plug any of these data sets into the input data. And that gives you a chart showing in this case the temperature for each day in the year for every hour of the day. So basically you see that the hottest time in Central Park is from somewhere June, end of May or middle of May to end of September, and hottest month probably June, July. To these two are the hottest, and hottest temperature is around here, obviously in the afternoon, early afternoon. The chart was loaded, but if so what you could do now, you you can always actually add more charts in here. So wind speeds, you could put the wind speed here. Opala, that's not what I wanted. Let's do the dew point temperature, and with shift, if I click shift and put it into the input data, it actually allows me to put more than one input data. So you can see that the chart are kind of weirdly offsetted, and the reason is that the data correlates with this C position. So I know that my lowest data here is -15.6, which would be translated to -156 if I would basically add a point into my scene with, yeah, so with a C value of 156 to counter that offset, then I could place here a point and then that will shift my to zero. That means my chart starts at zero regardless of the negative value here. Kind of depends, you know, if I think actually it makes kind of sense. And but what you can also do, you can shift this manually later when you baked it. You can shift it wherever you want. But what you can also do is to remove this disconnect dew point here, and we can just get another chart. And now let's check something else, like the wind speeds, for example. That of course it was wrong. Let's connect the wind speed. So again, it would do the same. It will basically place your lowest point to zero, but this time because there's no negative wind speed, so but I can still move my diagram to another point. So I could get this here, take this point and just shift the whole diagram. Yeah, so now we have it on the same level. Here's a crazy storm. Must have been a crazy storm. Sometimes data is not 100%. I mean, there can be always like mistakes. So that looks kind of as a wrong value. But actually, I've seen this in another data set as well. So in theory, we could actually get two sets, right? So we can compare different sets. So I could actually go here and check. So we took this one. Yeah, took this one. Let's try this one as well. And let's copy. Looks like the exact same data set. So I could turn that off. of, maybe it's the same data set. Anyway, so what can we, what else can we do? We could add conditional statements here. In order to do that, let's get a panel. And let's place it here. And we can say A is more than 25. Let's try that. Yeah, works really good. So it now it shows me only the temperature above 25 degree. That's pretty good. Now we could do the same here. Let's get wind speeds below a certain point, maybe below 9. So you can see wind speeds below 9, or you could also maybe, what do we have here, maximum 24. This, I think it's not real. Maybe let's say, because 24 meter per second is a lot. So what we could go to, let's say above 15. That's crazy fast already. Yeah, that's what I expected. So it's way too much. Above 10. Okay, that's already makes a bit more sense. But that way you could also then like draw some conclusions. So it actually looks like as if temperature, the hotter the temperature, the less wind. That means there is maybe not enough air exchange, and that's why it's heating up inside the park. So let's make this a bit low so we see a bit more of the data. Let's say everything above 8, and here we can go and choose. So yeah, you can actually argue that the less wind, the hotter it gets in the park. Of course, there are maybe other conditional statements. Just I guess we could say, for example, A is either larger than 25 or smaller than 15 or 10, let's say. And that should actually work. So let's check it. Yeah. Of course, we could also say A is either, just to have the optimum. So what is the optimal temperature? The ideal temperature for humans would be, let's say, 21. So it's larger than 21, but smaller than 25. So in that way you would see then on which day is the perfect temperature to go to the park. That didn't work. Of course, sorry, my fault. And I need to end. Condition statement would be end. Yeah, so. So then, now I know on which days, during which time, I would have the ideal conditions to go into the park. In during June, from June to September, during the time 12 to 6 in the night until 6 in the morning is the best temperature, and then again in the evenings, and here also in September shifts more to the afternoon. So that must be a really nice time, the perfect time to go to the park. What else? So we could also use a different statement. For example, we could use A is the wind speed. A would be 10, for example, then it would give me only the events where my wind speed was 10 or was not 10. Of course, sorry. Now you can see there are some holes in the diagram. You can actually see, okay, there. Here it was, the wind speed was 5. Or was not, basically it shows everything which is not 5 as a wind speed. Let's change this here a bit so we have see a bit more of the data. Let's save. What is still comfortable with clothes outside until temperature where it gets uncomfortable hot, 27. Now the color is a bit, this doesn't work because we don't see text anymore. That reminds me that we should do one tutorial about how to adjust all these colors, so that would be another tutorial. So I think that's it. In the next episode, we might have a bit more look into how to visualize the weather data. And then we go into the environmental analysis. I will not go through every tool. I think that would be too much, but some of them. Well, so I hope that helps. And yeah, please subscribe. And hit the bell button. And if you have comments, I'm always up for it. Thanks for watching.